What's happening, everybody? Jeff Lightsy Jr. here with the Black Boss Channel. Be sure to hit the thumbs up button, like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Tell a friend to join us here on the Black Boss Channel. Now, today, we are here to on the Free Bradley Beal campaign. I'm the number one executive, number one chanter, number one proponent of getting Bradley Beal the hell out of Washington, D.C. I know he loves the D.C. market. I have friends that live up there. They're telling me Bradley Beal loves living in D.C., but the man is miserable playing for the Wizards. I mean, at least when John Wall was there and they weren't winning, or they were somewhat, or at least when John Wall was there and healthy, they were somewhat competitive. But at least when John Wall was there the last 2 years injured, at least he had his friend with him. I don't even know if him and Russell Westbrook are friends, and we'll get to Russ later because Russ is playing horrible. But Bradley Beal is lighting up the league. Bradley Beal is dropping 40 night in and night out, and they lose every single time. Bradley Beal leads the league in scoring. He's averaging over 30 points per game. Bradley Beal is doing his thing, and somehow, some way, the Wizards find a way to lose. The team is horrible, but you need to blow it up. Boom. You need to blow the whole thing up and get Brad out of town quick, fast, and in a hurry. And you know who needs to come calling, who's going to make a play for Brad? And don't be surprised, because my man is as smooth as the other and cool as the other side of the pillow, as smooth as a snake. It's Rob Pelinka. That's LeBron James. Somehow, some way, moves like this normally go in LeBron James, and especially LeBron James, but even Rob Pelinka's favor. Somehow, some way. Now, Bradley Beal is owed a ton of money. And I had a friend, shout out to Marcus Lamar from the Mark My Word show. He says, why in the hell should we be saying free Bradley Beal? He signed the extension. And when you sign the extension, you get what you deserve. And you getting paid $30, $40 million a year, you get what you deserve. And that's cool. Like, I mean, yeah, Marcus, you kind of right. But no, you're wrong. Because here's the thing. NBA players dictate what the hell goes on in the NBA. I think the NFL players are starting to figure out that they can kind of do the same thing. We saw Jalen Ramsey do it. We're watching Deshaun Watson do it. We're starting to see it more of a trend in the NFL. NBA, it's always happened. Hell, it's happened one big time this year. James Harden, he said, I'm done playing here in Houston. I'm ready to go. It's time to go. And guess what the hell they did? They shipped him out of town. I think of Bradley Beal, which he has not. And that's the thing about Brad. And I will say, I will commend him on this, because he is not someone who just forces the issue. It's a lot of people like me and a lot of talking heads talking for Brad. But we see it. Like, we physically see the man on the sideline shaking and holding his head. And we like, bro, get my dude out of there. He's playing his heart and soul out for this team. And you got Russell Westbrook, who's averaging 18 points a game on 30% from three, still can't shoot. Russell Westbrook, who refuses to change his game, getting all these stats, chasing rebounds, stealing rebounds. The man's averaging a triple-double. Look it up. Russell Westbrook averaging damn near a triple-double again. But it ain't working, because the Wizards are the worst team in the Eastern Conference, have the worst record. Bradley Beal leads the league in scoring, and they still have the worst record in the NBA, or worst record in the Eastern Conference. Bradley Beal literally has scored in his last 10. Bradley Beal has scored 40 points per game several times. 40 points, several games. In the last 10, he has 0 wins in 10 times, his last 10 times scoring 40 points. Zero. He's 0-10 in the last 10 games. He scored 40 or more points. That's unacceptable. That's not cool. Like that, get this man out of town. Please, Lakers, come save him. Clippers. And I would say the Clippers, the reason why the Clippers don't make a lot of sense, because it's only one basketball. It gives them more firepower. It gives them a hell of a lot more firepower. Bringing in Bradley Beal, shipping off, who's the guy they just signed? Luke Kennard, shipping off Luke Kennard, shipping off Patrick Beverly, shipping off like another guy or two. It gives them hella firepower. But I think you run into the same thing you run into with Brooklyn. You have three guys that need the ball, and especially in a triangle offense. The triangle offense is centered around getting a guy a bucket, isolation bucket. That's why Paul George is having a career year. That's why Kawhi Leonard is doing his thing. And that's why the Clippers are tied for our second place in the West. And Utah is number one, but nobody really scared of Utah. So getting Bradley Beal to the Lakers, that would be huge. Why? Because the Lakers have LeBron James. because the Lakers have a pass first LeBron James. He averages 25 a game, but he's pass first. LeBron James is a point guard, essentially. Like, he's always in the league, top of the league in assists. He led the league in assists last year because he wants to pass first. I would love to see Bradley Beal in L.A. Heard he bought a home out there. The campaign to get Bradley Beal to L.A. is starting right now, and it's starting with me. Bradley, let's get Bradley Beal to L.A., y'all. I'd love to see it because he needs to get out of D.C. I know he loves the city. I heard he loves the city. But, man, it ain't getting the job done. Scott Brooks, Russell Westbrook, it's a match made in hell. Like, not heaven, in hell, because they're playing horrible, and Russ is playing horrible. I think I saw a stat. Russ, in his last 163 shots, has 163 points. Think about that. In his last 163 shots, he has only scored 163 points. You do realize that you get 2 points per made basket. You get 2 points, not one per basket. You get 2 points per basket. And that man is getting 1 point per shot. That's horrible. That's all I got to say. That's pretty horrible. Once again, I'm Jeff Lightsy Jr. with the Black Boss Channel. Be sure to hit the thumbs up button, like, share, subscribe. Tell a friend to come join us here on theblackbosschannel.com. And follow me on Instagram. I post content on there all the time. All kinds of stuff from the NBA. All kinds of stuff from being B1, Black First. And we will see you guys.